Now, children, we'll see the format of how to write the email. Now, please, I know we have already done it, but when I was checking your copy, you had made ample of mistake. So now, this thing, while revision, go through, try to understand and grasp it, so that you do not make any mistake. I told you, you get only 5 marks. And you can easily score that 5 marks in your writing skill. Right. First, we will write. You will leave one or two lines. Two lines. Then what you will do? You will write from. Make 2 dots, which is called semicolon, and write the sender's email ID, which is of 0.5 marks. Remember. So remember, children, when you are writing your email ID. Or from or that these dot. Do not try to make any error that if one red pen mark, you miss that 0.5 mark. Right. Second, after from you from you will write just beneath 2, then make 2 semicolon. This you will make a semicolon and write receiver's email ID. Again, receiver is the person to whom you have sent the letter. And this is email. That is of 0.5 marks again. So make sure this is only a 0.5 mark. Kehte hai na, boon boon se sagar banta hai. But you, this thing, if you are careful and this thing, try to obtain that 0.5 marks from from here, you will be able to score at least 4, 4.5, right, in the email. So try not to make any mistake. Now date. Now for the date, you know, first comes numericals. Numerical for the date is either single digit or double digit. It should be written in double digit. If it is first, so you will write 0, 1. Okay. Since today is what? Today is 29. So I am going to write over here 29, October, O-C-T-O-B-E-R, October. Now here you will make a comma and year. Year is of how many digits? 4 digits. So what year it is? 2020. Again, if you write correctly, you will get 0.5 mark. Then comes the subject. Subject should be in one line. What is the content, like matter you are sending the email? So it is of 1 mark. Then salutation. Salutation means salutation is what? Salutation is like dear. Yeah, hello, your respected ma'am, your Mr. So and so, that is salutation. Then comes the main body. Main body is of 50 marks, it should be of 50 to 20 words, not more than that. If you try to write more than that, it will be dangerous for you, because that might be a negative point for you for the deduction of marks. Because the more content you write, the more you make a mistake. Grammatical mistake or spelling mistake or such. Because in the English, even spelling mistake is being marked. Right? And over here, for the body content, it is for how much marks? 2 marks. So, short, sweet and crisp information it should be. No writing the full story and details or Ram Katha and all. Right. Then comes a subscription, that is yours sincerely, yours faithfully, yours respectfully, etc. And then your name. If you write, now I'll tell you how to, like, what are the ways to end. Right. Now after every now you will leave one line here. Now this, as I told you, keep this part, to, from, date and subject. They are called headers. Like after headers, you will make leave a line. After salutation, again you are going to leave a line. After the main, when you once you have written the main body, you will again leave one line. So leaving a line is what it makes your email look more beautiful, right? It does not make, because writing on paper, on the screen, it looks okay. But when you are since this is an examination, you have to show it in on the paper. So therefore, it should be written neatly, and the words which you are writing should be visible, right? So that is why if you leave one line over here, it will give a good look to your email. Now let's see. I'll give you one example. When we will discuss one example, suppose you to write email. Now children, you know that email are basically like are of three types. We have studied. One is formal email, secondly is informal email, and thirdly is semi-formal email, right? Formal email are the person you don't know, but you are writing an email, right? So formal email is the one you are writing the letter to those people that who are your family member, who are your close people, your friends. So you are free to use like whatever like words, sorry, in the salutation I'll be talking about. And then is semi-formal is what? Semi-formal is the person, you know the person, but you are not that friendly. Like when you are working, when you start working, so people who are working under you, or the people you are working and you are directly reporting, so your colleagues, your boss, na, so you send email, right? So then email is called like a semi-formal email. But since this is the first time you are writing on paper for the examination, email, so we will focus on the formal email. Why I have selected informal email. Why I have selected informal email? Because you all are very young, but you are very smart and intelligent. I know that in the uses of uses of technologies like laptop, computer, your phones, etc. So you will be able to pick up very easily, and moreover you all also do chatting, use Instagram, so you will be able to learn and grasp easily, right? So from you will write the sender's sender's email, because without this the message will not go. And to the receiver, email ID you will write, date I have already discussed, the matter. Suppose if you are inviting your friend for your birthday party, so what you will write, the subject as I told you should be in one line. So you will write invitation, I-N-V-I-T-A-T-I-N, invitation for my birthday party, right? Yeah, you can also write invitation for birthday party, anything, right? Then you will leave line. Since you are writing to your friend, so what you will do, you will say, dear, over here you will write dear, anything you will say Ananya, A-N-N-A-Y-A, Ananya, comma. Then you will write the matter. You will write the matter over here. So as I told you, it should not exceed more than 80 words, right? Because the more you write, the more mistake you will do, because it is of only 2 marks. And for the subscriptions, so the person you know generally, what are the things that we you use, that is regards, love, or you can say this thing, yours sincerely, yours faithfully, hai na? These are the this thing for substitutions you can use. So since she is your friend, you can say yours sincerely. Yeah, you can write regards. Best she is regards. Regards, comma, then you will write full stop. Then you will write yours is this thing regard. Then your yours loving friend. Friend, comma, and your name. Say it is Anshika. A-N-S-H-I-K-A. Dadi Amma has sent the letters to Ananya Soni. Right? Yeah, yeah, she. So, you can say this is the format. Now, I will be giving only on the info email for the this thing. Informal. It could be like invitation for your birthday party, invitation for your marriage party, marriage of your brother, your sister, anything like that. So, I hope you must have understood. Take care of yourself and study hard. Right, children? And don't make a mistake which you have repeatedly done in your class or copy. Right? Have a good day. Hello, children. How are you? I hope you must be good. Now, in this revision session, I have come with the lesson number 27, that is email. I'll be focusing only on email, how to write in a proper and a systematic matter, a method. Because when I was checking that now, you know that you gave your copies for your correction. And some of the children, like not all, but some of the children were making ample of mistakes. Because that is why, because you all don't watch. So I decided to make a very short video for yourself. Right. So, coming to it, like email is one type of writing skill and it is very important because it is going to come in the examination till like even for your board exam. We are training you from now for the board exam. So, be very careful and try to cooperate by understanding, right? So, it is of 5 marks. It is of 5 marks. Now, when I will be explaining the format, I will be writing the numbers also, like the marking scheme also. So try to understand. It is very difficult. It is not very easy to score the marks, that marks, because for one line, it is marked for half marks. So one silly mistake, gone. Right. So over here, email, children, is an electronic communication, which is a communication, matlab talking. Like sending your thoughts, views and messages. So it is, this email is done, generally done through with the help of, you can say, computer, laptop or mobile, right? Now for the email, like when you are like formally, if you are writing, it is like you can write no word limits. But since this is for your examination, right? So there is a word limit. For the examination, there is a word limit. So, which is very, very important and you should keep it in mind. It should not exceed more than 50 to 80 word limits. Remember, children, the more you put, you write, the more you make mistake. When you know that you have little marks, so it is better talk to the point, right? So, the second point which I am going to tell you, since it is a restricted of writing this much numbers of words, so my points, my message should be to the point, short, or you can say crisp information, like on the detail, and dot to the, like whatever information you want to give, write that when there is a marks to be given, right? So, and thirdly it is, which is very very important and which I have noticed when I was collecting the copy, that all the emails should be written in a box. After writing the message, you should make a box. But none of, very few, one or two children, like I take three section, out of the three section, I can say hardly in my fingers, like five fingers, I can count them. I can easily count them, like not even like five children they were. So please, whenever when you are writing a message, this thing, email, first thing is that do it in a fresh paper, word limits, to the point, the message should be crisp information, right? And after writing the message, then you will be making a box, right? Now next we will be discussing about the format, so listen carefully.